sometimes you can't think of the name of a movie. This is on the bottom. Why I didn't rent the car so long. I think I'm crazy.
I might be able to identify the accomplice.
Accomplice?
Yes, it's like a fellow returns to the scene of the crime. Oh, it happens. And just in case, I wanted to have it on film.
Lieutenant, what accomplice? There is no accomplice. Dexter murdered my wife. The evidence is overwhelming.
Well, there's no question Dexter was in on it. And most of the fellows down in Boston, you know, they'd like to close out the case. But I'm sure someone else is involved.
You're wasting your time.
Well, a couple things bother me. You remember the ransom note? You remember it said, we have your wife, and we will contact you.
But that's just a figure of speech.
Well, it could be. But don't take plenty of money. Mr. Dashford is only recently out of prison, has no known employment, yet we found a couple hundred dollars in this man's wallet. And he never had any trouble paying his motel bill.
This will prove anything.
Well, the parole officer seems to think it does. I spoke to him yesterday. He says he was trying to get Dashford for a job. And when Prince Dashford said something about he was working on something else, he was never very specific about it. And the real estate agent, Mr. Gruden, he's absolutely certain that Dashford bought that property in his own name or for someone else. So you can see, sir, how all these things add up.
No, not to me, Lieutenant. Dashford was a convicted extortionist. Very clever man. Now, I only know when I read the newspapers about it, but he did always reform, didn't he?
Yes, sir, that's true. But then there's always a first-time record. Well, look, I won't hold you up any longer. I want to apologize again if I caused any disturbance.
All right, Lieutenant.
One more thing, sir. I almost forgot. One more thing that I wanted to check on. It's probably not important. Could you excuse us? That phone call that Dashford made the morning after your wife was taken, we checked on that. And the call was definitely made by Dashford from his motel room.
Yes.
But I was talking to your housekeeper, Mrs. Morgan, and she tells me that your meeting with that man was at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Is that correct?
That is correct.
How much time elapsed between the exchange of shots and your getting to the phone booth to call the police?
Well, I did all that very quickly. 10 minutes.
10 minutes. So now your phone call was received at police headquarters at 5:45. That's recorded. So that places your meeting with Mr. Dashford at around 5:30. That's very hard for me to understand.
What is very hard for you to understand?
Well, it's hard for me to understand, sir, because if it was my wife and the man who had taken her said to be there at 5 o'clock, I'd be damn certain that I got there on time. I said we didn't want to keep him waiting.
I never said that I went directly to the auto junkyard. Now, the fact is, I received a phone call. I was ordered to go to a pool room, wait for a car. Now, I don't know, maybe Dester was checking to see if it was a trap. The call came to the booth. I was directed to the junkyard. That's simple.
Well, that would explain it. Where is that phone booth, sir?
It's somewhere in West LA. I'm not sure the exact location. It's near a gas station. I can find it again if I have to.
That's funny. I mean, those kind of things are hard to remember. I mean, going into a strange area of town to find a strange phone booth, and I don't think that you, Oh, wait a minute, I got it right here. No, you didn't. I didn't think you did. See, now I can't figure out this small note that you made to yourself when Dexter called you about the ransom.
It'll sound crazy. You wouldn't believe the crazy things we heard.
Try. He's back in business, but is he ready for the next chapter? The new season of Castle continues Wednesday at 9 on Family USA. Do more with the huge summer sale at Ibis Hotels. With up to 25% off rooms, it's always cheaper at ibis.com. Ibis, stay fit. fabulous. A few days ago, we had back pain. Struggled to bend, jump, or crawl. I don't believe it. What happened?
Boy.
Newspaper paste, the camera. Ballistics match that gun of his to the
weapon to kill Mrs. Gillespie. He made the phone call, the ransom phone call from his motel room, the Gillespie home. Guy's a two-time loser for extortion. What does he need?
No, I know he's driving around in cabs.
Are you
a the real estate man. He makes me a cab, so I didn't bring nothing out. Then I go to the camera shop, and I saw that telling him that's what goes up in a cab. Well, don't you know that Deschler reports to the parole officer when he leaves? The officer's looking out of the window. And as Deschler's in the middle of the street, he's hailing a cab.
So what?
Well, the problem is serious that all of a sudden, on Thursday the 20th at noon, the day of the kidnapping, he rented a car.
You didn't expect him to kidnap Mrs. Gillespie in a taxi cab, did you?
No, what bothered me was, why didn't you rent a car early? Why didn't you rent a car on the 10th, or on the 8th, or the 9th? Listen, it's expensive to drive around for 2 weeks in a taxi cab. Why do you save money? Rent a car soon.
Yeah, but why are you wasting your time?
Because it bothers me, and I couldn't sleep. I kept thinking about it, and I think I came up with the answer. The reason he couldn't rent a car earlier is because he was just out of prison and he didn't have a driver's license. Now, let's just save money.
You said you had something to ask me.
Yes, sir.
I have this.
problem, wouldn't we? You remember my idea of taking pictures out of the cemetery?
Oh, yes, your phantom accomplice.
I'm afraid it didn't work out too well.
He was a good one.
But I'm not sure.
These are the worst pictures I have ever seen.
I absolutely did. There was a new camera. I borrowed it from a neighbor to explain how to use it. Then I got confused.
What's this one?
How strange that Mr. Dashman would take this picture and throw it away.
What's the purpose of the picture? Lieutenant, that is not a good picture. The exposure is way too light. The framing is off. Everything's way off center.
The framing?
It's not a good picture, Lieutenant.
You know, you're right. You see, now that you mention it, I see it. Well, it goes to show you what a bad photographer I am. I guess Mr. Dashman's like you. Well, I mean, he must have been unhackable. I mean, a perfectionist like you. Otherwise, why would he take another one?
Well, Lieutenant, photographic composition is talent. You're born with it, and you obviously are perfect.
Well, I'm not gonna argue with you, eh? But you know, I wish I had that ability. Because next month, well, I think I mentioned this to you. My brother-in-law, next month he's celebrating his 20th anniversary party. Actually, I was thinking. Could you drop by and take a few pictures? It's nothing fancy. Oh, we'll all have a good time. We've got a big spread there, and you'll be able to play bocce ball.
Lieutenant, I'm afraid that's impossible. First of all, I don't drop by and take pictures. And secondly, I'm leaving on my 13th trip next Monday.
Oh, sorry, sir. I didn't realize that. Listen. Maybe Mr. Rack is his assistant?
No, she'll be working with me.
Oh, I didn't realize.
Sugar. Great cup taste with zero sugar.
Drift.
themselves going no further than the car. Tony, he knows where you live. He's going to take the two of you for a little ride. If you can't drive your car after an accident, direct line of your own insurance will get you a taxi to continue your journey. I'm going to cover your car. Now, before you go, why don't you forget your doctor?
She just got more shoes from Just That. Every month, shoes, shoes, more shoes delivered for free. Is that too crazy to you? Why do you need so many Just That shoes?
Because I worked hard. It's my money, and it makes me happy.
Those are good reasons. I was just.
I'll make some dinner. Visit justthat.co.uk. Shop hundreds of styles for £35, plus free delivery.
To a Now TV Sky Cinema Pass and check out the latest blockbusters like these. Start your 40-day free trial and stream over 1,000 movies on demand, including the latest big screen hits, as well as favorites, all without a whip on a contract. And with all these, there's a movie for everyone. Start your 14-day free trial of over 1,000 movies with no contract. Search Now TV.
The pillow everyone loves. Protection. Dettol disinfectant spray kills 99.9% of bacteria even on soft surfaces. Dettol, what it takes to protect.
How many hotels does Dubai live in? Tell you about JanePlan. JanePlan is a calorie-controlled diet that's delivered straight to your door as a choice of over 70 dishes, tasty, nutritious meals that can be prepared in minutes. JanePlan could help you lose weight and feel great.
Since I've done JanePlan, I genuinely feel like I've got my mojo back.
And if you order at JanePlan.com, you'll save £100. Go direct to JanePlan.com or call 1-800-377-7078 now. JanePlan, the diet that delivers.
Fancy a 4G smartphone at a small price? You'll save £120 on BT Mobile phones if you've got BT broadband at home. Making the Samsung Galaxy J3 even more value at just £12 a month. This Galaxy A3, £17 a month.
It's busy.
Well, there's a wonderful turnout here. Here it is.
something, Lieutenant, but I'm not a drinker.
What?
Oh, that's right. Good, you're probably on duty anyway. You are on duty, aren't you?
Yes. You know, it isn't every day that I go on a complete promise on a book. But that's beside the point. This is a terrific book. I'm up to a place when I find it 6 times. Do you know how many photographs you have in this book?
Lieutenant, I have never counted my book.
You took 522 photographs. 522 pictures. You took 522 photographs. And I have to tell you something. I've been to San Quentin a few times. You know, in the early days, I used to take prisoners up there. And I want to tell you, you've really captured the mood of the place. It's very depressing.
Well, Lieutenant, Cameron is like an artist fella. Tool is nothing without the art. Look at this one. I brought that into the Ukraine with me. Must have been 11 years ago. It was even more than that.
You were there 7 weeks, sir?
What?
San Quentin. It says there in the jacket, you were there for 7 weeks. You worked there. You slept there. You ate with the prisoners.
That's right.
May I show you something?
Mm-hmm.
You see that?
Mm-hmm.
You see that man in the background?
Yes.
That's Mr. Desher.
Mm-hmm. Why, yes, I believe it is.
You know, when I saw this book in your office, and I realized that you spent that much time in San Quentin, I knew I had to walk by it. You know how many other photographs Mr. Desher is?
Oh, Lieutenant.
Nine other photographs, Mr. Desher. Wait a minute. There's another one. See that?
Mm-hmm. All right. Right, Mr. Desher.
But, sir, in your sworn statement, you said that you never met the man.
Oh, Lieutenant. Surely you don't expect me to remember one obscure man from the thousands I photographed over the years? I didn't know the man's name.
Not his name, sir. The space. Your business is spaces. I thought maybe you would have met him when you were at the prison.
Well, I didn't. And even if I had, I would have. But then, maybe. Maybe he remembers me from that business. And probably knowing that I was well off, he picked me for his next victim.
That's possible.
You don't think so, huh, Jimmy? You believe that somehow I'm responsible for my wife's death.
Oh, no, no. Deny it, Lieutenant. You're like a little shaggy-haired terrier.
He's got a grip on my father, he won't let go.
I can't turn around without you staring up at me with that blank, innocent expression on your face. I won't deny, sir, that I have problems with this guy.
Lieutenant. Please. Don't you think he's been through enough?
Sorry, you're going to be a lot sorrier, Lieutenant, if you don't stop following me around. Now, in 2 days, I'm leaving for the Philippines. Miss McGrath here. And for 8 blessed weeks, I won't have to be greeted with your suffocating presence. Or are you planning on going alone?
Oh, no.
Well, in which case, I'll scream until the beams at City Hall shake.
That won't be necessary. I know I've been affected. I'm just trying to do my job. I won't bother you.
Oh, I hope you mean that, Lieutenant. For your sake and for mine.
Wait, would you just fill that out, please? Department of Motor Vehicle, Lieutenant.
Yes, ma'am. This is Lieutenant Colombo. We spoke the other day.
Oh, yes, I remember. You were asking about Mr. Weekly.
Weekly, yes, ma'am. That was the man's name. He said he was out of town. He said he'd be back this morning. I wonder if I was
late. I'm terribly sorry, Lieutenant. He's not here. In fact, he's stranded out on the road. Some sort of car trouble.
Could you give me that, that location where he's stranded?
I give you a toll advance. I told you they ain't gas and you ain't a new fuel.
Lady,
you can stay here all day.
Mr. Wheatley? Mr. Wheatley?
Yeah?
They told me at the office I could find you here on Lieutenant Colombo on the police. I can ask you a few questions. I hope you don't mind.
My lunch hour. I'm hungry. Here.
Is there something I can do, sir?
What did you have in mind?
Are you stumped?
It's obvious, isn't it?
I guess it is.
Well, then why ask?
Well, I thought it might be helpful if I gave you a lift.
That would be helpful, yes.
Where are you going?
To the office.
Of course. Right this way.
Is it safe?
The car?
Yes.
Absolutely.